Hujambo, karibu kwa darasa letu la leo. Jina langu ni Abdul Karim. Today's lesson is about the noun class of UZ. As you know, or if you don't know, the Swahili nouns are guided by a special rule called ngeli. So if you know ngeli, then it means you know Swahili. Okay, we have different kinds of ngeli in Swahili, and I talked about the ngeli of awa, the ngeli of kivi. The links to the video is in the description section. Go click the links, watch those video and understand them. So today we are going to talk about this ngeli ya UZ. So the nouns in this category are used in our daily lives. So we start. When forming a sentence, the verb phrase takes the prefix U. Yani it starts with the prefix U. That is especially for this category of noun class, UZ. That is U. So the first U, verb phrase takes the U, and it begins with U, okay, in singular form, and Z in plural form. That's where we get the term UZ. UZ. So the verb phrase takes or begins with U in singular form and Z in plural form. That is when you are forming a sentence. This video is categorized into two parts. The first part, we are going to talk about general these the nouns that are included in this category. So then the next part, we are going to talk about the examples, how to use these in a sentence, these nouns in a sentence, how your Swahili sentence will be when using these nouns. Okay, so if you have a pen, notebook, stay keen, then note down the important points. The types of nouns in this category are: 1. Those that begins with U, those that begin with U in singular form, and mbu in plural form. Sawa sawa. Examples are ubawa, 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 mbawa, 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 ubao, 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 mbao, mbao, ubavu, ubavu, mbavu, mbavu. Let's go to the second category. Those that begin with U in singular form and nyu in plural form. That is NY, pronounced as nyu, nyu, nyu. So you'll hear the pronunciation in the examples here. Examples of nouns are uzi, 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 nyuzi, 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 ua, ua, nyua, nyua. Actually, this word ua, it means the fence or something that is surrounding a place. Fence, you know, it is surrounding, it is enclosing something. That is the ua. Another ua means flower. Ua is a flower. Then the plural for flower, that is ua, maua. So that is different noun class. Ua, maua. Okay. Also, ua means to kill. To kill. That is a verb. It means to kill. So, ua here, the fence, that is a nyua, plural. Nyua. Nyua. Then we have unyasi. Unyasi, plural is nyasi. 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 Okay. So number 3, nouns that have u in singular form and ndi in plural form. Examples is ulimi. 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 Ndimi. Ndimi, ndimi, ndimi. Uwele, 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 ndwele, Ndwele. Uwele is another name for ugonjwa. Ugonjwa is disease. So uwele is another name for ugonjwa with the plural is ndwele, magonjwa, diseases. Okay. Number four, nouns that have W in singular form, then new, N-Y, N-Y is new in plural form. Example, wavu, nyavu, nyavu, nyavu. Wakati, wakati, nyakati, nyakati, this is times, eh? Nyakati. Wimbo, wimbo, nyimbo, 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 okay? Number five, those nouns that have u in singular form, but they have no, they don't have the big initial prefix in plural form. So that is, it means the u is dropped and no other prefix is added. Okay, so we have ukucha, ukucha in singular form. Then in plural we have kucha, kucha, kucha. That is a nail, nail, nails. So nail, nails. Okay, not nails, the one used by carpenter, but the nail and the one that is in your fingers. Ufito, ufito, fito, fito, fito. Ukuta, ukuta, kuta, kuta, kuta. Welcome to the second part of this lesson, where we are going to talk about these nouns in a sentence, examples of these nouns in a sentence. So I would like you to be very keen and notice how the verbs involving these nouns are used. And if they have the initial u in singular form, then z in plural form. So the first example, ubawa umepotea, ubawa umepotea, ubawa umepotea. Plural will be mbawa zimepotea, mbawa zimepotea, mbawa zimepotea. The second example, ubao, ubao wako umepakwa rangi, ubao wako umepakwa rangi. Mbao zenu zimepakwa rangi, mbao zenu zimepakwa rangi. See? Umepakwa, zimepakwa. Okay, that is z u u z there. Example 3, unyasi wangu unateleza, unyasi wangu unateleza, nyasi zangu zinateleza. You can say nyasi zangu, my grasses, or nyasi zetu, our grasses. Nyasi zangu zinateleza, nyasi zetu zinateleza. Okay. Example 4, we have ulimi hauna mfupa. This is a Swahili proverbs, and this statement is in a negative form because it is a true statement. The tongue doesn't have the bone, doesn't have bone. Ulimi hauna mfupa, ndimi hazina mifupa. So if we form this sentence in a positive way, it will be ulimi unamfupa, and that it does, it is actually, it does not make sense unless when used as a figurative language. So ulimi unamfupa, it is a lie. Yeah? Ulimi, the tongue has bone. Actually, it's known that the tongue doesn't have bone. So when you say ulimi unamfupa, you are lying. This proverb ulimi hauna mfupa is used when apologizing. For example, when apologizing, for instance, you just say something accidentally, that can cause harm to others, and you can apologize by saying pole ulimi hauna mfupa, pole ulimi hauna mfupa. Yani, it means that you didn't intend to say that thing, and it just slipped from your mouth. like the tongue doesn't have the bone and it will have controlled itself, but accidentally it just came out, okay? Okay. Number 5. Wavu umenunuliwa. Wavu umenunuliwa. Wavu umenunuliwa. Nyavu zimenunuliwa. Nyavu zimenunuliwa. Number 6. Ukucha huu unapendeza. Ukucha huu unapendeza. Kucha hizi zinapendeza. Kucha hizi zinapendeza. So that's all about these nouns in this category and how we use them in a sentence and how the verbs that relate to them they look like. If you enjoyed this video, kindly click the like button. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, kindly click the subscribe button so that you don't miss any video about Swahili that I upload. Asante sana. The next lesson, we are going to talk about the noun class in the category of UE. Remember, this one is UZI and the next will be UE. I talked about the noun class of AWA and KIVI. So their video links is in the description section. Kindly go check and learn and understand your Swahili vizuri sana. Kwa heri. Kuwa na siku njema, kuwa na wakati mwema.